Hey guys, welcome back to our channel, Sports Freak TV. Today we are going to watch the best moments of women's long jump finals from the Olympics. Women's long jump final event at the Summer Olympics took place on 1st and 3rd August 2021 at the Japan National Stadium. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe our channel.
Tyra Gittens is already
Gittens first jump.
Did to get a clean jump to start, but her face does not show too much impressed.
She's 6 meters 30 in a zero win.
Second to jump, Brittney Reese, the Olympic champion from London 2012. An impressive start.
You can see 660 with 20 odd centimetres lost on the board, that's 680. So
here's another contender at her third Olympic Games, Brooke Stratton.
We accelerate into the board, they just prepare for takeoff by just dropping the hips.
Ivana Španović, bronze medalist from Rio. She can perform at the highest of levels, as all of these athletes can. What could she bring out on her first jump?
Well, she'll take the lead with that one, that leg shoot into the sandpit. She'll take an early lead, 671 for Španović.
One of the favourites, if not the favourite, Malaika Mihambo. Here we go. She set down an impressive starter mark.
It's firm, it's fast. And you've just got to get some of those runway runs into your legs. 683, she takes the lead from Španović in this early stages. Now we have the Nigerian coming up for her first jump. Here's my interpretation. Look at that, 697.
Next up, Maryna Bekh-Romanchuk, sure she has put that behind her. This will be an important moment, and it was not a good start.
It's that she's got a bit of an eagle. But it...
Next to jump, Abigail Irozuru. She had a strong jump, improved actually on each jump in the qualifiers.
Let me tighten up on my landing gear. Aston Moore in the crowd there, the British coach. Rookie position, lady.
Chantel Malone getting ready for her attempt at number one.
Compromise the speed and the accumulative acceleration that you need to really hit that board and take off, get a better jump. But it's still not bad, 650.
It increases when they come. And now look at the smile on Tara Davis. She has come out onto this. That are actually down next to the long jump area.
And she's off for her first jump in this women's final of the long jump. We had 12 of those 17 onto the jump. Well, it's not a bad effort, but again, a bit of decelerating. So 662 for Tyra Davis.
Jazmin Sawyers going through her mental process as she strides down the runway for her first attempt.
Very positive in her outlook in terms of approaching that board.
But he's relaxed. But now it is Khaddi Sagnia from Sweden on her first attempt.
She actually was the youth champion at triple jump and she didn't qualify.
Well, here we go for her second attempt. Tyra Gittens, 6:30, her best so far.
Improved to 660 with a minus win.
time. But right now, it is Brittney Reese, one of the most decorated long jumpers. She just looks so relaxed, doesn't she?
Shoots out into the pit. Look at those 2 feet staying together. Just falls back a little. Well, 681 up into third for Bree.
Brooke Stratton looking for the white flag on this second attempt.
See that there's a different bounciness about the ability to take off on that board.
She'll be relieved to have a score on the board after that first no jump, so 6.52. Ivana Španović, a 6.71 already in the qualification.
Got 6.91 for Španović.
Can she start to put pressure on those jumpers at the top?
We start from below. Those arms are a little untidy, but the legs are functioning perfectly well and just clipping. 6.95, Mihambo.
Leading the competition. Great first jump by the Nigerian.
Got to put by fraction, we're talking fractions here, and then you've got to put it right in the air, and it's a balancing act between speed, takeoff, pressure on the board, and all that picking off at the same time.
Head from the coach, that's actually 30 centimetres less than her opener, jump the first time. She qualified on her first jump.
To see. Quite nice on the one where that tape would worry me. It's the takeoff foot and the knee flowing easily, and your nerves are sort of flying around and they can't be controlled.
Abigail Irozuru on her second attempt. That looks better on the board.
6.89 position at the moment. 6.89.
Chantel Malone, her second attempt. So a lot of adjustment on the first jump and that run up just...
Inability of the legs to take the hit of these foot contacts on this surface at this moment in time.
Tyra Davis with all that energy she's on that face.
Yeah, she's got the lead by the American. 6.67, slight improvement. She holds fifth place.
One of those who might be feeling the pressure.
Last stride, just to make sure she got that takeoff foot on the board. There, great on the right foot takeoff. Just short.
Plenty of experience, a 6.80 for...
Progress up the board.
Khaddi Sagnia, 6.58. She needs to better that to keep herself in a safe position in this final.
Well, it could be a slight improvement. In the air, it's just rugby. 67, and she sits seventh place as we go to the third round of this women's long jump final. Really important because it goes to count back for what you've done best.
Oh, Gittens with the best of 660. Doesn't look like she's managed to improve much on that, if at all.
And she's been pushed down in just wait, no, slightly best, so yes, very nervous times for Gittens as she sits.
See what the experience of Reese. Are we going to see something impressive here?
That could be the first one over seven. On the run-up, she almost looks she's hunting some four medals here. And look at that, 6.97.
Seven, but it's a 6.52, the best so far for Brooke Stratton. Her third attempt.
Going to be close, but I think it's the clenched fish, so yep, 6.83. It wasn't close at all, sir.
You can. She'll be delighted to have got that jump in when... 6.91. She went 7.2 in fourth, coming into the third jump.
Well, it's peppering that 7 meter line, isn't it? She seemed to just cut a stride into back up jump to that 6.91.
Press through this competition.
And the wind here, you know, she had a plus 1.3 in the first round, and then it went down to plus 0.6.
Well, far off the plasticine there, and that didn't help her efforts.
6.78, so that would have taken her very close to 7 metres.
At the Rio Olympics, 5 years more of training, 5 years more experience. And it's starting to show.
She's in.
Hard to score, to get the white flag and make it through the next stage.
Well, that's the way you do it. Bit of pressure. What's pressure? Loses the tension that's helped to get out to 688.
In those positions with Irozuru. Under pressure herself. She's got to get a big jump. And you can see the 8 line there.
To 627.
She's going to have to produce something. 667 or better is what's required.
Missed the board, falling short on the board, and that causes all sorts of knock-on effects then to as you take off and get into the air.
In 8th competition.
With that takeoff board, much better from Davis. 681 and puts her in 7th place.
And to the jumper after her, Khaddi Sagnia, but the only one that was this year, so she's obviously in good form.
Version of horizontal to vertical with that block of the foot. Just looked as though she's shooting you up into the sky. 653.
Movement. Can she deliver under this pressured moment? Well,
Sawyers will be 658, though, last. See that? 2 on 697.
Usually, I don't know how many other sports will have the same, but it is Sawyers who is in 8th position, so first to jump.
Well, she is a bundle of energy at takeoff. You know, before, so it's a good backup jump to that 680.
In 7th place, but she has improved continuously. Might be close to her previous, or look at this, she at just 22 years of age is, so Stratton finds herself in 7th, London. Very long run up.
If it was me, I'd get tired, and I think she did too on that one.
It's Olympic position, she's still in 7th place.
Stride, and the coaches in the stand will be saying the same thing. Come on, get your run up, sort of.
Has she now relaxed into it? Are we going to see something special? Well, she struggled on those first two to get her foot placement correct and quite getting her foot down in time, but when she does.
679, that's personal best. 68, not personal.
91 in her second attempt.
Well, it's like the old ad terms, even left back, but it's in the plastic, no job.
To the Olympic Games. The clap as well, sitting nervously, just 2 centimetres longer than Mihambo. Well, save the energy, she's got 2 jumps left, she sits. Not bettered her opener.
So if you go back, you suffer the consequences. 688.
At this long jump competition, 697.
Yeah, and interestingly, you saw that Reese does this hang technique, not leg shoot as such, or the stride, you know, the bar almost. It, like, it was melancholy on the runway. And then tightness, instead of just staying nice and loose. 687. Now we've got 2 rounds left.
I like it. It's building. Well, we're ready for our 5th jump. And that looked a bit long. A strong jump earlier on. Jump number 3. Jump number 2.
You just don't want to leave anything out on the track side. You want to give absolutely.
Champion. Tyra Davis still smiling.
Top on this jump.
It's still consistent, isn't it? She might have just improved again on her.
683.
Oh, she's consistent. Result, a 6th.
They won't be threatening the leaders in this competition. hit the board and fly past 7 meters to be a person.
Again, one thing. No, she can do it. She's done it on this runway 2 days ago. She stays in that fourth place.
Regular throughout the season in the normal competitive season.
Getting in the bronze medal position though.
It was definitely threatening 7 meters out into the sand.
It was, but is she bring her real A game? 6.95.
Wow, and Carl Lewis fighting out with world records littering.
It's been so close between her and Brittney Reese. She's not managed to better before this last round.
The ears watching Brittney Reese jump. She is a fantastic competitor, and it wouldn't surprise me. Better than the Nigerian second jump. How close? You can't.
Distance has not changed.
That's exactly,
I mean,
it.
It's incredible.
Okay. Has to jump position until that last jump because she jumped 6.95.
An Olympic Games. What can she deliver now?
Running on the run up, you know, that bundle of energy is converting that 9 to 80 in the second round.
Brooke Stratton, she's going to move up the standings. Long run up. Campaign.
Awarded jump on her sixth round of effort.
At the top, there's nothing huge coming from lower down the rankings, but Tara Davis could be one of those nominated by the Olympic stage. She's performed consistently on the last five jumps. And again, a long way off on she's her. Come. She has given it.
And she records 6.71. Six jumps, so.
Bekh-Romanchuk, can she do something special? Can she get the white flag on her final jump? Well, she went big, but
with 6.88, but getting up there and she'll finish in fifth.
Look under those shades.
So chance had gone, but you just tighten up the takeoff. Walks away, 6.72. Not a bad jump.
For the reigning world champion, Malaika Mihambo.
Mihambo, this is your moment, or is it not? Good speed.
Well, there's gasps from the crowd.
If it does, then we have a new leader, and perhaps we have 3 centimeters determined.
The bronze medal position, unless she can better 6.97. Well, it looks as though it wasn't quite enough.
Into the sand.
Nigerian.
And that looks like it's not quite good enough. 6.90.
Reese guaranteed a silver with that.
In a bit of jumping here. What's happened? The leg shoot went out. We get 7.
Brittney Reese wins the silver medal. It's Malaika Mihambo who becomes the Olympic champion with that final jump. We said it would be a 7 meter jump.
Picks up another medal in this long jump, this event, which is fantastic to watch, and you move from one position to a...
Well, she kept us on the edge of our seats, didn't she?
You see things happening, and you just think, Mihambo, she's, you know, she's a tall athlete, got to explode off it. And there you go, in the last round, she got it. And then to snaffle them all in the last round. Thanks to you, I've become inspirational.